October 24th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, Lamentations chapter 4, from the Old Testament. Alas, gold has lost its luster. Pure gold loses value. Jewels are scattered on every street corner. The precious sons of Zion were worth their weight in gold. Alas, but now they are treated like broken clay pots made by a potter. Even the jackals nurse their young at their breast. But my people are cruel, like ostriches in the desert. The infant's tongue sticks to the roof of its mouth due to thirst. Little children beg for bread, but no one gives them even a morsel. Those who once feasted on delicacies are now starving to death in the streets. Those who grew up wearing expensive clothes are now dying amid garbage. The punishment of my people exceeded that of Sodom, which was overthrown in a moment with no one to help her. Her consecrated ones were brighter than snow, whiter than milk, their bodies more ruddy than corals, their hair like lapis lazuli. Now their appearance is darker than soot. They are not recognized in the streets. Their skin has shriveled on their bones. It is dried up like tree bark. Those who died by the sword are better off than those who die of hunger. Those who waste away struck down from lack of food. The hands of tender-hearted women cook their own children, who became their food when my people were destroyed. The Lord fully vented his wrath. He poured out his fierce anger. He started a fire in Zion. It consumed her foundations. Neither the kings of the earth nor the people of the lands ever thought that enemy or foe would enter the gates of Jerusalem. But it happened due to the sins of her prophets and the iniquities of her priests, who poured out in her midst the blood of the righteous. They wander blindly through the streets, defiled by the blood they shed, while no one dares to touch their garments. People cry to them, "Turn away, you are unclean. Turn away, don't touch us." So they have fled and wander about, but the nations say they may not stay here any longer. The Lord himself has scattered them. He no longer watches over them. They do not honor the priests. They do not show favor to the elders. Our eyes continually failed us as we looked in vain for help. From our watchtowers we watched for a nation that could not rescue us. Our enemies hunted us down at every step so that we could not walk about in our streets. Our end drew near. Our days were numbered, for our end had come. Those who pursued us were swifter than eagles in the sky. They chased us over the mountains. They ambushed us in the wilderness. Our very life breath, the Lord's anointed king, was caught in their traps, of whom we thought under his protection we will survive among the nations. Rejoice and be glad for now, O people of Edom, who reside in the land of Uz. But the cup of judgment will pass to you also. You will get drunk and take off your clothes. O people of Zion, your punishment will come to an end. He will not prolong your exile. But O people of Edom, he will punish your sin and reveal your offenses. God, this might seem a little bit odd, but the biggest thing that my heart latches onto in reading this particular chapter in Lamentations is the fact that the judgment ended. And with everything else going on, that they deserved the judgment, that their judgment went on longer than Sodom because your people knew better than Sodom did. Sodom was an instantaneous thing. Your people had to endure this punishment for a long time. But for me, because I've been under punishment from you before, I've been under discipline from you before, and even though I know it's done out of love to help make me a better person and to teach me and all of these things, for me it is also helpful and supportive to know that your punishment does end. I remember growing up and always wondering when my mom was going to not be mad at me anymore. Once I caused her to be mad, I would do everything in my possible realm of trying to make her like me again. And I obviously misunderstood as a child, and and carry that into adulthood, that I translate punishment as somebody who's taken away their love from me. And you know that I'm working on that. So to me, it is helpful to know and read stories like this that the punishment has ended. It means to me that you truly are punishing us out of love. You are trying to make us more like the people you created us to be, and we've gotten off track. And it definitely comes from a place of love. So again, it might be a little bit odd, but just the fact that their punishment ended, and then you went after the nations who laughed at them for being punished by their God, to me speaks volumes about this place I exist in this world, where I know I don't deserve your love. I know I don't deserve your forgiveness. I know I don't deserve your grace or mercy, but somehow we have this relationship where you love me, and you love me unconditionally, and it's so overwhelming and so baffling to me, and I am truly blessed and thankful for it. When I'm being disciplined, my first reaction is, yep, knew it, too good to be true. Now God hates me. I know it sounds so silly, but I know my heart. I know where I go to. So reading these stories of punishment and the process and the reconciliation and the ending of that punishment and why you really did the punishment, that it is for your glory, that it is to bring us into alignment with your will, all of those things teach me more and more about my relationship with you. That it is a healthy relationship, unlike a lot of relationships I've had in the past, is a healthy relationship where you love me so much that you want what is best for me. God, I thank you for teaching us and helping us grow within these stories that you show us in the Bible, that even though they happened thousands and thousands of years ago, they're so applicable to our lives. If we'll just take a moment and realize and be honest about what our heart is and where it's at in a relationship with you, it allows us in these stories to grow from that point, if we're being completely honest where we're at. So I thank you for sharing your punishment of your people and the process that they went through. In your Son's name I pray, amen.